If you want to store your seed phrase on a metal device to make sure it will last a lifetime, what are the best options? Unfortunately, a lot of expensive seed phrase storage devices get annihilated when it comes to heat, corrosion, and physical damage, the exact things they're supposed to protect against. So which products will last and which won't? And do you have to shell out $100 or can you get a bomb-proof option for much cheaper? Luckily, a guy named Jameson Lopp has already rigorously tested 49 different seed phrase devices against heat, corrosion, and physical damage. After spending several hours reading and cataloging all the results into a more searchable and sortable spreadsheet, this video will condense the time it takes you to digest all the information on his website. In addition, with the spreadsheet I've made, you'll be able to sort by all the different parameters that matter to you, like device style, whether or not the data is concealed for tamper evidence, the grade it received on each test, the price with tools, and the price for three separate devices if you need multiple. Most of that information isn't searchable or sortable from Jameson's website, but I've got to give credit where credit is due, and it all goes to him. On the spreadsheet, I've only listed the products that are still available for purchase. Some products have doubled in price since Jameson originally posted, so you can be confident that what you are seeing on my spreadsheet has the up-to-date information. If you're watching this video a year from now, let me know if anything is out of date, and I'll update the spreadsheet as well as include the revision date for everyone's benefit. Now let's summarize the results. There are six categories of devices that passed all the tests. Engraving, handwritten with an electrical Dremel. Stamping, taking a metal stamp and hammering the letters onto plates. Etching, similar to engraving but not motorized, just scratching your letters with a really sharp tip. One method even uses a mini acid bath to deepen the scratches. Punching, using a hammer and punch to make holes or deep indents on a plate. Stacking, by stacking pre-made letters onto a rod. And finally, tiles, where you sort pre-made letter tiles onto a metal holder. To prove each device could stand the test of time, Jameson exposed each one to a 2,000 degree Fahrenheit flame for 10 minutes, then dunked them in cold water after to simulate a house fire and sudden cool down that would come from firefighters putting out the fire. Then Jameson put them in strong acid for 12 hours to make sure they could withstand corrosion, then crushed them under a hydraulic press, just for good measure. The category that failed the most frequently was the tile category. The heat caused the devices to warp in non-uniform ways and tiles would pop out of place, leading to permanent data loss. The acid had similar effects, and if it passed the first two tests, then the compression and bending in the third test would pop the tiles out of place even more. Only two tile devices passed all the tests, Simbit and Cypher Wheel. Beyond those two, this is the category I'd avoid. The category that succeeded the most frequently was the punch category. Big indents and chunky pieces of metal is difficult data to erase or obscure. The only time this category ran into problems was that when the lines delineating the data wasn't deeply engraved enough. Then you'd have a harder time determining what letter or number each indent corresponded to. This was rare though, and most punch devices did amazing. As for the rest of the categories, some products did great while others did poorly. It was just more product specific. To help narrow your decision, I've only included products on the spreadsheet that were rated a B or higher by Jameson. You might start by sorting the spreadsheet by price, then sorting by device style. When you do this, you'll get a comment-only version of my spreadsheet. So to properly sort the spreadsheet, click a column, then Data, Sort Sheet through A to Z. Then edit your temporary filter by changing A1 to A2. This will put filters on top of each column so you can sort by whatever field you want. The reason there are four different price categories is because I thought it would be helpful to know the costs with and without tools. Do you already own metal stamps, a punch, or an engraver? Or do you know someone you could borrow it from? I also calculated the cost of purchasing three devices because I wanted to see how well the costs scaled. If you want multiple backups, or you choose to do a Shamir secret sharing scheme, then it's important to know how much buying three will cost. You can also sort by currency because products listed in your local currency will probably have reduced shipping costs. I also want to explain what the data concealed column means. This refers to whether or not an onlooker could just see the data by looking at the device. The reason some people might want this is so that they can put it in a tamper evidence bag to know if the data has ever been exposed while in storage. If Jameson adds more test results in the future, I'll be sure to add them in. After spending hours with all the different results, I have some recommendations. If you're looking for a one-and-done solution, easy to set up, easy to read, bomb-proof, I'd get the BitPlate Domino, specifically the BitPlate Domino 1, because that way you don't have to do any of the double dot patterns required for smaller BitPlate options. But if the double dot pattern doesn't bother you, then you can get one of the cheaper BitPlate options. Currently, it is 55 euros for the Domino 1 and 40 for the Pocket Domino. If you want something that will take the least amount of time and hassle to set up, then the Black Seed ink plate is a great option. Basically, just write your letters while pressing hard. You can tell from the pictures it's not quite as bomb-proof as some of the other options, but it definitely passed all the tests. It retails for $27, and if you buy three, it only comes out to $16 a piece. If you are going for the cool factor, then CryptoTag is a sleek-looking option. It's expensive, though, currently retailing for $129. Ouch. Kind of feels like you're paying for marketing because, according to Jameson's tests, it doesn't seem like there's any additional security in comparison to a typical punch plate. Also, Zeus, which is the cheaper of the two, has you store the BIP39 numbers rather than storing the first four letters of your BIP39 words. So there's a higher chance of a transcription error than just saving the first four letters of each word. The version that lets you stamp the letters rather than the numbers is the Thor, the $350 option. If you've never used a seed storage device before, you might be confused as to why some devices only let you store the first four letters of each word. You will need the full word when you go to restore your account, so why only store a part of the data? The reason is because the words have a special property. There are no two words that will ever share the first four letters. So to save space, you don't need to store the whole word. To see this list, go look up the BIP39 word list. If you're cheap, like me, then I'd go for the Safu Ninja method. You buy 24 stainless steel washers, then stamp a number onto it for your word order, then the first four letters of each word onto each washer. You can also buy a stamp guide to make hammering the stamps in easier and look a lot more appealing. This is also the most scalable solution because you can get washers even cheaper if you buy them in bulk. Another cheap DIY or do-it-yourself option is the SafeSeed DIY, which is also relatively cheap. In general, for do-it-yourself solutions, you're looking for stainless steel, copper, or titanium. Just make sure to avoid aluminum because of corrosion and warping at temperature. If you do go with stainless steel, I'd try to stick to a 304 stainless steel. For reference, that is what is used in the Safu Ninja test with the washers. Grade 304 stainless steel is great against corrosion, but won't survive being stored long-term in salt water. I'm not quite sure why you would want to do that, but if you did and you were some scuba diving pirate treasure hunter, then research grade 316 stainless steel or other marine solutions. Another product from Jameson's test I feel is worth mentioning is the Crypto Key Stack. I feel like it got a lot of things right. It looks cool. You can buy it with or without the logo, and it comes with an electric graver all for $45. And it performed great on all the tests. So those are my recommendations. Feel free to look through the rest of the spreadsheet to see if there's an option you'd like better. If you're watching this video, then it means you're serious about securing your crypto. So please remember this, a backup is not a backup until it's been tested. If you haven't tested your words to properly restore your account, then it's not a true backup because you may have written it down wrong. Don't trust yourself that you did it right. Verify it so you can be 100% sure. And while we're on the topic of securing our seed phrase, I'd recommend learning two more concepts if you aren't familiar with them already. Go look up what a BIP39 passphrase is, called a 25th word, and what a Shamir secret sharing scheme is. Of the two, Shamir is my favorite, but they are both used to protect against different scenarios. Good luck securing your crypto, and thanks for watching.